I never know. Sometimes I say this should only take 10 minutes and then it takes like 25. So I have no idea. Today's the fourth and we are beginning the second half. It's not going to feel quite like a half because I don't think it'll take as long, but the second part of this unit. So what we've done so far is we've talked about y equals mx plus b. You guys know how to get y by itself, graph lines. You know about horizontal lines. You know about vertical lines. You're really good with slope. Like we've done a lot. So what's left to talk about is writing equations. And then the new one for today is we're going to see a new format of equation, and it's called point slope. This one is super useful. It's not quite as useful in like a direct sense as slope intercept, but it's in a very special way. It's a great quick way to write equations. So this is point slope form. Is what we're going to talk about today. And in case you have no idea what I'm talking about, that let me give you sort of an overview. This one is what we've been working with. And what's that one called again? Right. So that is called slope intercept. And there are three forms that we're going to talk about in this class. One of them, y equals mx plus b. I kind of call that like water under the bridge, right? The new one for today, and there's a third one that might come up just kind of organically in the lesson. It might not. So I'm not going to talk about it on purpose. But the second one is the one that you're going to talk with me about today. And it's this one. You're going to want to write this down. It looks confusing, but it's actually this. The easiest one directly to just work with. I don't know why I say stuff like that. Like it's, I guess it depends on the context, but that formula looks hard, but it's really actually quite easy. So the first thing I made a note to myself that I wanted to say to you guys is that there are five variables in here. You can see that, right? Only three of them get replaced with numbers, and I'm going to draw little arrows to them. This one gets replaced. This one gets replaced, and this one gets replaced. And once I show you what I mean by that, you'll be blown away by how absolutely simple this is. Like, it's crazy simple. The y and x I did not point to, those are like the skeletal structure. Those remain the variable values in the equation. So we don't replace those, they stay. So let me give you an example. Let's say I told you that I wanted you to write me the equation of a line that has a slope of 1/2 and passes through the point -1, 8. What an interesting situation that is. And by the way, we can't use y equals mx plus b for this because the point that I gave you is not the b. It's not the y-intercept, right? It's just some random point. So what we're going to do here is we're going to plug numbers in where those green arrows are pointing. Now, there are three of them, and we're going to be smart about this. This 1/2 is going to go in place of m, of course, right? Because we know that slope is m. And where do you think the -1 is going to go? It's the x coordinate of the point. So it's going to go in place of x(1). And then where do you suppose the 8's going to go? In place of y(1). And it really is a simple process. You take that red equation up at the top of the TV and you just rewrite it. But every time you get to one of the input slots, you just change it into a number. So, red equation, here it goes. It currently looks like this up here. We're going to change this, this, and this. Simple. So, what is the left side of the equation going to say? I love it. Any questions so far? I just put the y coordinate right in there, and then I'm going to put down equals. What's the next thing I'm going to write?
Oh, 1/2
Good job.
parentheses
Yep.
x minus -1 plus 1 plus 1.
And we've seen this before, right? We've seen this sort of theme with these formulas that if the formula has a minus in it and we put a negative in after the minus, then they come together and make a plus. This right here is called point slope form. And it's what we're going to be writing our answers for, like for at least a day, probably two. So you don't have to do anything with this right now. Like, I'm not going to have you convert it over into slope intercept or anything like that. That comes later. So all we're going to practice over and over again today is the art of just plugging numbers in and getting point slope equations. Now, that expectedly takes 5 minutes. This next one should be able to be done in about 30 seconds. So let's say we have a slope of negative 3/5 and we go through the point negative 12, 5. Ready? Let's go. What's the point slope equation going to be?
I equal negative 3/5 parentheses would it be x plus 12?
Yep. That's it. Simple, huh? Okay. About this one. What if I told you that the slope is 1 and we're going to go through the point 2, 9? What's this one going to be? Correct. The question I get a lot is, do I really need to write it like that? And the answer is nope. It's kind of like in math, we've talked about this, that sometimes ones go places and we go, we don't really need it. And so people like me tend to not put it. This answer could also be written as y minus 9 equals x minus 2. You see that the parentheses are just there to allow the slope to multiply. But if the slope's a 1, then like, what's the point, right?
Thanks, Jim.
Right. Now, there are going to be some examples today of problems that you don't want to try to write in point slope form. For example, and if you've fallen asleep, just kind of perk back up because this is a little bit of a different vibe here, a problem like this. So let's say I tell you that the slope is undefined and that the line goes through the point negative 4, 10. It's tough to fit this in today's lesson because here I get you rolling on this y minus y sub 1 thing, and then suddenly I throw this curveball at you. Does anyone want to take a flyer shot at what the equation of this line is? Don't try to write it like the other ones. It ain't going to work. What kind of line has an undefined slope? Well, yeah, up and down is fine with me. Some people call it vertical. You can call it up and down. Whatever you call it, know what it is. Good job. So if you already know that the line's going to be vertical, how do we write the equation of a vertical line? You know this from yesterday's quiz. We write x equals, and which of these two numbers do you think we're going to pick? Done. That is the equation of the line. The y coordinate is meaningless because, as we know about vertical lines, they all have the same x, but the y's are like, who cares, right? On a same very related note, let's say I told you that I had a line with a slope of 0 and that it's going to pass through the point 5, 8. What kind of line has a slope of 0?
Why?
Horizontal. And horizontals, very good, Cal, are y equals. And which of these numbers are we going to pick?
Eight.
And that's how you write the equation of those. So that's the first part of the lesson. That's just generally how you use point slope. I mean, it's literally just plug it in. The only exception, again, is the vertical and horizontal. Those are always the oddballs because they don't fit the mold like everybody else. And you'll see it in your delta math. It'll say, write everything in fully simplified point slope form unless the line is horizontal or vertical. And so these are what it's going to look like when it's horizontal or vertical. All right. For the second half of this, I'm going to flip over my note card. And now we are going to write the point slope equation of a line that passes through the points 1, 4, and 3, 8. This is new. This is the second part, so watch out. What changed from 5 minutes ago to now? What's different? Correct. That's going to become a pretty common theme, is you're going to look around and say, what do I have and what don't I have? You're going to take inventory. And having the slope is a pretty big deal. Like, I gotta put it in front of those parentheses. What am I supposed to put there? What do you think we do when we don't have a slope? You find the slope. Good. Good answer. So we've got the skills for this. We know this. We've been tested on this. Help me find the slope. Would you, what would be my top subtraction problem for the slope? Eight minus four. So I'm going to write that down. Nice. And what's going to be my bottom? Three minus one. Knowing how to find slope makes you a pretty powerful mathematician. You can do a lot of things in math. So I'm going to get four on the top and two on the bottom. What is then my slope?
Two.
Correct. Now, there's a question here that anyone would ask. Any logical person who's paying attention would want to know, okay, I see where you're going with this, but which point do you want me to pick? Do you want me to pick the yellow one or do you want me to pick the purple one? What do you think the answer is? It doesn't matter. Your answers are cooking today back there, Nashville. It doesn't matter. And sometimes people go, well, how am I supposed to get the right answer? There's two right answers to this question. Eventually they come back to look the same at some point, but for now, it's okay. Like if Jeff does it using the yellow point and Peyton does it using the purple point, their answers are going to look totally different, but they're both correct. So what would the point slope equation be if we use the yellow point? I'm ready. Help me out. Four equals
No,
times
minus one. Jeez.
it's okay. We got a little rusty there. We went on a sidetrack and we got a little lost, but now we're back on the path. Help me with the purple one.
Y minus eight, two, x minus three.
Good. And I'm just going to show you something just so that you don't question this. This is not part of today's work. I just want you to see something. A lot of people really struggle to say that those are the same line. I'm one of those. Like when I was a kid, I was like, you cannot tell me that those are the same. That's a load of baloney. So here it goes. Again, this is not part of today's work. This is a future thing. I just want you to see it so you can say something like, huh, cool. Let's make these both into y equals mx plus b. Help me with this. Help me distribute. What do I get?
Two one minus two.
And then we got to add four to both sides, right? So what do we get? Y equals 2x.
Plus two.
Remember that. There it is. Now let's go do the purple one. Help me distribute. I'm terrible at distribution. What do I get? Now, how do we get y by itself? Look at that. It's just, I wanted you to see proof positive that the yellow and purple equations are literally the same. When you choose a different point to use in point slope, it might look different to you, but it actually is the same thing. You can see how the two white equations are the same. All right, so let me blow through a couple more examples and then I'm done. So the next one is this. We're going to go, and by the way, that last part, we're not going to do that every time. Okay, but you can if you want to, but we're not going to. Not as a class, not yet. So our first point is negative three, negative three. And our second point is three, negative one. And the question is again, what are we missing? And the answer is slope. And any mathematician knows if you don't have slope, you just go find it. Get her done. So what's my top subtraction going to be? I love it. Right here, negative one minus negative three, negative one plus three. What's my bottom math problem going to be? Three plus three. Make a fraction, do the math. What's negative one plus three?
Three.
What's negative one plus three?
Well,
Two, three plus three, six. Slope is one third. And this time, let's just pick one. Okay, I'll take the first one I hear. Do you guys want to do yellow or do you want to do purple? Yellow it is. And so what is my, you're not allowed to answer anymore, Nash. You're doing great, but I would like to hear some new voices. Like anyone over here, anyone over here, because you're just going a little bit, you're really fast. Anyone else want to pony up?
I minus, we're doing yellow one.
Yellow.
All right. Y four plus three
Yep.
equal one third, then parentheses x plus yeah, plus three.
Done. Still good? Okay. Next one. First point is 5, negative 2. Second point is negative 4, negative 2. What are we going to do first? Let's find that dang slope, right? So we're going to do on the top, what's that math problem say?
Negative two.
And on the bottom, what's that going to say?
Negative one.
What's negative 2 plus 2? What is 0 over negative 9? We talked about this 10 minutes ago. The slope is 0. That's huge. What kind of line is 0 slope? Horizontal. Horizontal lines have 0 slope. And how do we write the equation of a horizontal line?
Go.
Let's say Peyton's like, I'm going to use the point on the left. And Josh is like, well, I'm going to use the point on the right. Look at what they have in common. They both literally have a y coordinate of negative 2, which begs me this question. Was any of this work even necessary from the get-go?
Yeah.
If I'm an astute, like if I'm observant and I'm going through this problem, if I keenly spot right away that the y's are the same, I can just write y equals negative 2. You see that? Having said that, we can go through the motions. It's fine. Or we can be observant. What do you notice? I should notice that the X's are the same. Huh? So if you want to go through and do all the stuff, you're welcome to. You could do the slope negative 2 minus 7, negative 2 minus 7, or over negative 1 minus negative 1, negative 9. And then you realize, ah, snap, that's an undefined slope. And undefined slopes are vertical lines. And vertical lines are, well, what I knew from the beginning, x is negative 1. You see it? The last thing I wanted to say to you is this. I made a comment. If I write it on my note card for you guys, then it's something that I think you need to hear. I know this because I was playing ahead of time. Your delta math assignment will count it wrong if you don't reduce your slopes, even if your point slope equation is really good. So, like, let's say I tried to type in like y plus 1 equals 6/8 times x minus 4. Even if everything is perfect, what did I do wrong?
In.
I didn't reduce my slope. And I know this because, again, I ran interference and actually took one for the team here and tried it out before you got here. And sure enough, delta math, that's what they mean when they say fully simplified point slope form. So even though this could be like a kid who totally knows what they're doing, if you don't reduce 6/8 down to 3/4, you'll get marked off. Does you have any questions? Righto. Your assignment's on the old daddy delta. Let's get her done. I'll keep the recording alive, but paused because I probably forgot to say something.